Welcome to the GLM model. That's what we want to consider. We want to consider the GLM model, and we are going to look at the Gaussian, we are going to look at the Poisson, and also the logistic regression models. So we are going to consider those three models. We have a number of libraries. We have the stats, which has the GLM function. We have the CAR, which has the VIF function for testing for multicollinearity. We also have the tidyverse, and also we have the fallen package for helping us to import the SPSS dataset into R. So our first step is we are going to import our data, and this data is a .sav, meaning it's in SPSS format. I use value.labels is equals to true, and to data frame is equals also true. So the first thing is we want to view our data. The data we are calling social, and see what components it has. So that's the data that we have. It has 1 to 6. It has 9 columns. It has 9 columns, and it has 1,400 entries. And I want to look at. I want to compare the income. We have 2 incomes. We have income 1 and income 2. This is income at the entry level. And the second income is income after 5 years. Did the income change after 5 years? So I want to see if income one is based on, it depends on gender. Any relationship between income one and gender and age. And so I'm going to use the Gaussian, which is a linear regression, because income one is a continuous variable. So I can mention here, I say that income one is continuous variable, so I use linear regression model. And how does it work? We use the GLM, which is under the stats package. So linear model, GLM, income compared to age plus gender. I'm using the data social, then I specify the model that I'm using, which is the Gaussian model. And therefore, if we check what's the summary of that, we're going to get some summaries, and we can see that the gender female compared to male is not significant, neither is age significant in that model. So they do not, gender and age do not significantly influence the entry level income. We could also, the first step actually should have done is to check if this multicollinearity, if the VIF is more than 5, you can see for age and gender, which are the independent variables, none of them is, all of them are 1. So saying that there is no multicollinearity, and that tells us that we are safe to have done what we are doing using the linear regression. We could also have tested for normality. The null hypothesis is that the data is normally distributed. Since our p-value is more than 5%, then it tells us to see that our data is normal, and that is a very good candidate for the income to be used for linear regression model. For the Poisson, there's a slightly different format that comes in. So when we use the Poisson, we should use count all integer data. And the only data in our case that is a count data is a household size. So I'm going to find out if household size has any relationship with age, income one, education and gender. And I say family is equal to Poisson. And I'm using the same data set, so I can still check. And I could do the VIF also. And it shows that all the variables and there is no multicollinearity because all my variables are at 1. I could do the summary, see what had an influence on household size. Age is not significant, income one is not. Education, yes, is those with primary compared to those with no level of education, those with secondary compared to no level of education, and those with tertiary, no level of education, they are all significant. Gender, we can also see When we compare with the female to male, we can see that the findings are significant. Now, if I wanted to find out how did I know which levels I have, I could have said, I could say that I want to look at my data on education, because we can see our primary, secondary, and tertiary. The question is, what is the fourth one? There are four levels. There is none, primary, secondary, and tertiary. So none becomes my reference point. And I've used the command or the function unique. So if I say unique for gender, there are only two. It's a male and female. So there is an explanation that we normally give when we are dealing with categorical or factors in our regression models, like the example that we have. The other thing I could have checked was, because I said that the findings for the indication are significant, I could have found out what was the average family size depending with your level of education. Because with none level of education, the family size is almost six children or six members in the household. Those with primary, they are almost five, that is 4.6 members in the household, secondary 3.9, and tertiary 3.8. We can see the number of households, so the household size decreases with increase in education. And that's why the findings were telling us that they are significant. So we could see that there was significant difference between primary, secondary, tertiary in reference to the category of none. Female and male-led households. The female here, it means a household. The head of the household is a female, and the head of the household is a male. There is also a significant difference. We could do also that to compare the gender and see how it comes out. And I could say mean gender. So there I'll pick that, and then this one I'll pick gender. And we might be surprised that there are some differences. So put it on mean gender. And between the, we can see that the male-led households, the size is 4.77, the female-led households is 3.99, and also these findings have been found to be statistically significant. Now, having said that, we want to move on to our logistic regression, and our family is the binomial. For logistic regression, we want to look at a mobile phone, if you have it or no. So for you to use logistic regression, your data must be categorical, or what we call in R as factor data. And in this case, we have mobile here, and the mobile is either yes or no. So if I say unique social mobile phone, it has two categories. It is yes or no. And that is a good candidate for logistic regression. I want to see if ownership of mobile phone is influenced by the entry-level income, your gender, your education, and if you use the bank. You also have to check the VIF. That is for the multicollinearity. That's the purpose of the VIF, to check for multicollinearity. And if I do a summary of the logistic regression model, I find that primary education compared with those with no education at all, the findings are significant. Then bank usage used to have and never had banks or usage before. So let's also again check the unique, which what are the levels in the bank usage, so that we see our reference point is currently have. So we used to have, never had. In relation to currently have, we see there is a difference, and we find that the findings are also significant. So that helps us to see that somebody who currently used to have compared to currently have a bank, have a mobile phone. And you can see that these values are positive. So a positive value here tells us that those who used to have a bank account have a mobile phone. Those who never had a bank account compared to those who have currently have, also the value is positive, telling us that they have a mobile phone. at the moment. But when you look at the Poisson, for example, yeah, in the Poisson, we are looking at the household size. And we are looking at primary level. Somebody with a primary level of education, the value is negative. So when you look at the primary level in reference to none, it says that if I look at somebody with a primary level of education compared to the one with no education, then the person with primary level has a negative estimate value, telling us that their family size is lower than the one with no education. The same case in all the three scenarios. And you can see the value, the estimate goes increasing, becoming a negative, a bigger negative, meaning that the higher the level of education, the smaller your family size becomes in relation to those with no level of education. And the same case would have been interpreted in the first case, yeah, in the first situation of the linear model. We could look at it again, particularly for the factors, gender. If you look at the income of a female compared to that of a male, then it means that the income of the starting income of a female ended household is lower because it's a negative than that of the male. So if the value is negative, it means it reduces the dependent variable of that factor compared to the other. If it's a positive, it means this one is higher compared to the other. So I have looked at the three scenarios of the GLM. We have the linear, we have the Poisson, and we have the logistic regression. So I hope that helps you to be able to distinguish the three and be able to do your analysis.